got to the school. He was pretty white.
A scare for a mother on her young son's first week of school. Tonight, two elementary school teachers in Hilliard are getting credit for quick thinking after saving the boy from choking to death.
New at 5:30, James Jackson joins us with more on their efforts to help him. James?
Yolanda, it was just after lunchtime when 9-year-old Evan Stiverson suddenly started choking outside. Two teachers ran to help, relying on training to save his life.
And the staff here.
They're an amazing group of people.
An emotional reminder through Kevin Stiverson's eyes that being a father isn't always easy. He and his wife, Candy, got a call Thursday saying their son, Evan, needed emergency help. Candy dropped everything, heading straight for Alton Darby Elementary.
When I got to the school, he was pretty white, just white as a sheet, and the office was full of people. Everybody was very concerned.
Around 12:30 that afternoon, Evan was on the playground when he started choking on a chicken nugget he ate for lunch. A student told phys ed teacher Chuck Burkhart, who turned him over, smacked his back, then gave him the Heimlich.
Then I tried to sweep his mouth and got a little bit out then, but he still was unconscious.
Then clinic assistant Sarah Jamie, who also had emergency training, came to his aid.
Started in pretty hard as I could. And it took about 5 big compressions and it finally came flying out, the whole chicken nugget.
Crews took Evan to the hospital. Doctors ran tests saying he was fine, just bruising on his chest and esophagus. The fourth grader has one word for his teachers.
Thankful.
Trained by nurses every year and ready for the unexpected.
They were clear-headed enough and calm and were able to, you know, carry out that protocol. We just can't be thankful enough.
Evan's parents tell us he's eating milkshakes, soup, and soft food until he's fully healed. He stayed home today and will likely return to school on Monday. James Jackson, ABC 6 News.
Great story, James. Thank you. Columbus police hope some...